I would like to, I humbly request our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Muhammad Aslam Parvez Sahab, to present a memento to our keynote speaker. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for your time. So let me introduce our chief guest, Mr. C. E. Kindo, Executive Director, National Mineral Development Corporation. Mr. Kindo is a mining engineer from ISM Dhanbad and carrying a vast experience of 35 years in production and mining in the Maharatna National Mineral Development Corporation. He has contributed a lot in organization at various levels and achieved an increment of tire life from 5,000 to more than 8,500, which is the highest in the world within a small period of time. सुना है बोले तो बात उनसे फूल जड़ते हैं ये बात है तो चलो बात करके देखते हैं ओवर टू यू सर
गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू लेट मी थैंक फर्स्ट द ऑलमाइटी हु हैज गिवन सच ए ब्यूटीफुल मॉर्निंग एज वेल एज ब्यूटीफुल गैदरिंग एंड स्मॉल बट ब्यूटीफुल ऑडिटोरियम आई एम फीलिंग वेरी हैप्पी फॉर द reason. I am in Hyderabad since last 1 year. I am not at all happy. But having entered this campus, I found it is something like the place where I spend my 80% of the life, free from all sort of pollution. Earlier speakers have told so many things. Before that, respected VC sir, Khandelwal sir, Suri sir, Madam Fatima, eminent persons sitting off the dais, ladies, and my dear students. I'm very particular about the students because when I was a student, I was very naughty. As of today, I am not like that. What I will say and speak is totally different than just now what you heard. I feel I am the most contented man on this earth, but most fortunate man, unfortunate man also, for the reasons. I am working in industry totally different than what you heard so far. I have seen so many accidents and fatal, not only accident, fatal death in front of me. In industry. That's why I will not speak anything that is written in the book. University used to teach, but I will speak from the bottom of my heart what I have seen, what I have experienced during 34 and a half years of service in industry. Even today I'm working in industry, but sitting in headquarter. Forgive me and please remind if I take long time, because I get have been very rare opportunity to speak with the teacher. What I am going to, to the student, what I am going to say is totally for the students. I remember a very small story. Once I had been to some place, I will not tell, otherwise you will come to know the incidents that have taken place. It was a engineering institute. There were they were bedfellows, bosom friends, very, very close to each other. One of them got a sudden call from his house. Possibly, mother is very, very serious. They thought of going to railway station. It was about far off from the institute, maybe about 30-35 kilometers. So all his friends accompanied him up to the railway station. After reaching over there, they found train is about 4 hours late. What to do during next 4 hours? They thought, why not to go for a movie? Lot of time is there. They went to nearby theater, booked ticket, and went inside the theater. After film was over, they came out of the cinema hall, went to station. They found that train is already standing on the platform, because somehow that it was coming from the far distance, it could make up the sum of the time. They started running. They went into the train, but they could not board in one compartment. They boarded in different compartment because by the time they reached over there, it started moving. Because they could not board in one compartment, they started searching each other. Within no time, because they were not able to get their friends, a sort of bustle was there in the train. People got surprised why these boys are learning like this. Nobody was even daring enough because they were in hurry. At last, they could not find the boy who was supposed to travel. They were sitting in one compartment, keeping their hands like this, what has gone wrong? Next station, they got down. It was maybe about after half an hour. This got another train, came back. After coming back to this station, original station, they found his friend is sitting in a very desperated way, holding his bag. They asked, all of them were very serious. They asked, what is the problem? Anyhow, we could not get, it is our mistake. He told, my mother is no more. What is wrong with them? Because we are talking about industry and opportunity of service, I want to give this example because I want to answer you indirectly how to get a job. Problem was with them. If you go through the background of the student, those five students, they were very intelligent as far as their schooling life was concerned. But after entering the engineering college, they felt they had a little bit different mentality. Now we are in the mainstream. We are damn sure that we are going to get a beautiful job, a lucrative job. After going there, possibly after joining institute, they were a little bit reluctant to study the way they should have done. Because the passion what they had during school days that they lost after joining engineering college. What I want to say, if you have got passion in doing something, I am damn sure you are going to achieve. Industry like NMDC, you must be knowing what is NMDC. It is National Mineral Development Corporation doing its mining activities. Anybody, if you say what is mining industry, they will say an industry where there is no assurance of life. As a mining engineer, I admitted it. Yes, mining is a very hazardous and dangerous job. But as an NMDC employee and under as of today, one of the most luxurious jobs. Mining industry is such an industry where you are not supposed to work.